Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to add a watermark to multiple photos in Adobe Photoshop. And to do this, we're going to create an action that will allow you to just click on a button and have it added. And I'll also show you how to automate it with a batch of photos. We'll also create a droplet at the very end. All right, let's get started. All right, I saved my watermark as a transparent PNG file, and it's right here. It's pretty big, but that's okay. And I have a photo in here too. I downloaded this from pexels.com, and I'm going to go ahead and open this in Photoshop. Now I'm going to open my actions, which is this little play button right over here. If you don't see this, you can come up here to Window and go to Actions here. And if you're seeing just a folder that says default on it, you'll want to create a new folder. And to do that, you'll come right down here to the bottom and click this folder button. I'm going to call this My Actions. And we'll hit OK. Now inside that folder, we'll want to create a new action. So I'll come down here and click the plus button. We'll call this Watermark. And the set will be My Actions. And we'll go ahead and record. Now Photoshop is recording everything we do, so we have to be a little bit careful that we don't record something that we don't want. Okay, so I'm going to come up here to File, Place Embedded, and then I'll navigate to my watermark, and it's right here, and I'll place it. It'll put it right in the center of my document, and this is a little bit bigger than I'd like to see, so I'm going to hold Shift and resize it all the way down to right about there. I want it pretty small. Now, if your watermark is coming in smaller than you want it to be, don't increase the size or it'll make it blurry. You need to go back to the software you created it in. Hopefully that's vector software like Adobe Illustrator, and then resize it as a larger PNG and save from there. Anyway, if it's too big, you can always resize it to be smaller, but you can't make something smaller bigger, if that makes sense. So I'm done resizing this, and now I'll just hit enter or return on my keyboard. If you decide you want to make it even smaller and you've already hit return or enter, you can hit command T or control T to get that back. But I'm happy with this, so I'll hit enter or return again. Another thing to think about is if you're going to be using this action a lot, which you probably are, the watermark file cannot be moved out of its current location. So out here where I've saved it, which is this folder. So you can't move it out of this location or put it in a different folder inside, or it'll cause an error in Photoshop. It won't know where to find that file. So always leave it in the same place. Next, I'm going to select all with Command A or Control A. We're still on our watermark layer here. And then I'll hit V on my keyboard to get to my Move tool up here. I want my watermark to be right down here, so I'm going to align it to the right and then align it to the bottom. So this is pretty close to what I want, but I want it to be offset. I want it to be up and over a little. So I'll make sure I'm on my Move tool, and then I'm going to hold Shift and use my arrows to move it over. Shift will make it move a little faster. So I'm going to do about maybe this far and up a little too. I'm holding Shift this whole time. And now we'll deselect with Command D or Control D. I'm going to open up my actions just to see how they're going, and you can see it's recorded everything we've done. Now I want to knock the opacity down here, so I'm going to go back to my layers, click on the watermark, and change it to about maybe 70%. I'll hit return, and this is looking pretty nice. I'll go back to my actions, and if I click this arrow, I can see that it's recorded my 70% here. And that's all we need to do for the action. So we'll come down here and hit stop, which is the little square button. Now that we have our action saved, we need to come up here to My Actions and click on that, and then come to the flyout and choose Save Actions. It'll open where all of your actions are saved, and I'm just going to go ahead and save it now. If you decide not to do this, if you happen to close Photoshop or if Photoshop crashes, this action will be gone forever. So you need to save it to have it come up in Photoshop when you open it. Okay, now I'm going to close this with Command W or Control W, and then hit D for don't save. Now I have a few photos that I pulled off of Pexels, and I'm just going to open a few of those and bring them into Photoshop. Now we can add our watermark with just one click. I'm going to get on the watermark action and just hit the play button. and you can see it's added it right down here. So you can do that manually if you want to. That way, if you want to resize or move it around a little bit once it's already in there, you can do that. So I'm going to go ahead and close out of these. And now I'm going to show you how to do a lot at once. So there are two ways to do this. First, the image processor, which is a script. So we'll come up here to File, Scripts, Image Processor. And now we're going to get a step-by-step of what we are trying to get Photoshop to do. I'm going to have it select a folder. Now these are all photos with no watermark. We want it to pull from this folder. So we'll open that. Step two is showing Photoshop where you want to save the photos with the watermarks. So I'm going to select that one. And I'm going to choose Z photos with watermark. It's empty right now. We'll open that. And then we'll choose a file type. I'm going to do JPEG 10 quality. And then we need to tell it what action to run. So I'll choose My Actions and Watermark, the one we just saved. So I'll go ahead and run this. And now it's opening all those files so it can add the watermark. Let's go look and see how it did. Okay, it made a folder named JPEG. And now I can look at each of these files and see that the watermark is right down here. Now the second way to do this is with Automate Batch. Let's go ahead and pull open our original photo, and I'm going to run the watermark action. With batching, you need to have it save at the very end of the action. So to do that, we're going to need to duplicate this action. So I'm going to click it and drag it onto the plus button. I'm going to call this one Batch Multiple. I'm going to come down here to the very last step and choose Record. And then I'll save. It's going to ask me where to save, and I'm going to choose JPEG. I'm going to put it right out here. Oh, oops. I guess I need to change the name. We'll add a 2 on the end. And we'll say OK. OK, so you can see it's saved down here as the last step of the action. So we'll stop that. Now I'm going to close this image and don't save. I'll come up here to File, Automate, and Batch. And now we get a similar dialog box to the image processor. I'm going to choose My Actions, and we want Batch Multiple this time. We'll choose a folder. That will be this Photos folder. And the destination, I'm actually going to come out here and delete this. We'll choose that same folder, the Z Photos with Watermark. Now, one thing you need to have checked is this Override Action Save As commands. Go ahead and check this because basically it'll stop the action and it'll cause a problem. So if you click this, it'll get rid of the problem. And here we've got document name. We can change this to a lot of different things. I usually leave it as just the document name and the extension it currently has. So we'll hit OK. And then it'll take a moment to think about this, and it's done. So let's go see how it did. We have the same result as the image processor. So really, the image processor just saves you a step. But sometimes you want to have a save at the end. And the reason for that is to create a droplet. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to go to File, Automate, and Create Droplet. Now, the droplet is a button where you can drag your photos onto it and it will go ahead and play the action and put them in a folder you want. And the photos at the beginning do not need to be in any certain folder. They can be on your desktop or wherever. So let's set this up. It's asking us where we want to save the droplet. The droplet is the button. I'm going to choose that same folder I've been working in. I'll just call it Watermark Droplet and I'll save it. I want it to play my batch multiple in my actions. We don't need to check any of these. Then my destination will be the folder with these photos, which I'll go ahead and get those out of there. So my destination is the Z photos with watermark. We'll choose that. We'll make sure this is checked and then we'll say OK. Right now it's not doing anything, which is fine. What we just did is create a button. But now we can come out here and see this button. And I like to keep these right down here on my dock. And then if I have a lot of photos, I can just drag those onto that droplet. And then it goes through the process of opening them and applying watermarks. So now we can come out to Z Photos with Watermark and see them. Any folder you happen to be in, let's say we're in here and we had a bunch of photos, we could just drag these onto that droplet and add the watermark. So this is very handy. All right, if you like this video, please click on the like button, and I'll see you in a couple days with another graphic design tutorial. Thank you.